I believe this is a psychological warfare campaign on the people more than it is a serious pandemic. I think there's a lot more going on than meets the eye here. In fact, I know there is. I mean, legitimate doctors and scientists are being censored and banned on YouTube constantly. It's unbelievable levels of fraud.
Hey everybody, Vince from Metal Sucks here, back with the Quarantine Cast, where we are on quarantine, and everyone is on quarantine because our nation cannot seem to get this pandemic under control. But on the plus side, it's provided a unique opportunity to talk to some of our favorite musicians who are also stuck at home just like the rest of us. So today, we have John Schaefer of Iced Earth, Demons, and Wizards. And John, are you still in Florida, or have you relocated since back in the day?
I left Florida in 1997, and I never looked back, man. I mean, I go back there because I have family and friends there, and I still do work at Morrisound, but no, it's I haven't lived there in many years.
And where are you now?
I'm in Indiana right now.
In Indiana, okay. Like, what's the vibe there right now as far as the pandemic goes? Like, are people out and about, or are people still kind of locked down, or like just specifically where you are, what's going on?
People have been out and about for a while. I think a lot of people didn't really go along with the program, here. So, which frankly I appreciate, because I believe this is a psychological warfare campaign on the people more than it is a serious pandemic. I think there's a lot more going on than meets the eye here. In fact, I know there is. I mean, legitimate doctors and scientists are being censored and banned on YouTube constantly. It's unbelievable levels of fraud. So I'm not saying that we don't have a problem, but the human race has faced this kind of thing for millennia. I mean, just goes on, and we don't shut down the global economy. The death and unrest out of these decisions is going to be 1,000 times worse than the virus.
The death and unrest from the decision of shutting down the economy, you mean?
Yes, exactly.
How so? Can you elaborate on that a bit?
Well, I think you'll see it. You're seeing it now, and you will see it further when the supply chains break down everywhere and we have a complete meltdown of the financial system. That's going to lead to starvation and death, and the third world will suffer from everything that's going on here. So it's this is we don't need to get into all this, because I think anybody that knows me knows where I stand, but I don't trust the government. I don't trust the bureaucrats, not at all, because I've actually read their game plan. I knew this was coming. I wrote about it, warned about it. People didn't want to pay attention. So, hey, it is what it is.
Well, I think this is good stuff to talk about, though, because, I don't know that I've seen, certainly you're a very outspoken person. You have been your entire career. I think that's what a lot of fans like about you. But I haven't really seen anything, I don't think, with regards to the pandemic. So, this is a good conversation. So, I mean, like, what, it sounds like your concern is that there will be disruptions in supply chain across the world, which, certainly we're already seeing that. But, what about the actual lives lost because of the virus?
Well, I think that's where we have to start questioning the data, the way the tests are. I mean, look, the information's out there. Turn off the television. I don't give a shit what network you're listening to. They're lying to you. And that's the reality of it. There's no excuse anymore in this day and age for people not to be able to figure out the tyranny that we're living under. There's just no excuse, but you need to disconnect from the mainstream media sources. And I'm not saying listen to Fox News, because it seems like there's a certain, you have, in this country, it's Pepsi or Coke. You have two choices. It's a duopoly on mind control. And I don't go for either one of those situations. So I'm just telling you, man, there's so much evidence out there. And if you understand the game plan of the handlers themselves, then you'll understand why I wrote the things that I did in Sons of Liberty, the things that I did on Dystopia and Plagues of Babylon, for that matter. Because I read their game plan. I've read their battle plan. I've read their books. So I know what they're up to. And this is not, it's not rocket science. I mean, it's literally about putting pieces of the puzzle together to see what the controllers of our society and what their vision of the future is and how they're going to get to that point. And this is just another move in this plandemic. So there's a lot to it, but I, you know, I've done thousands of hours of research, and it's just, you know, this is my understanding of the situation. It goes back, this whole movement is being funded by a very small group of people that are have very dark designs for the future of humanity and the world. And this is what's happening. I mean, it's just clear. You know, it affirms everything that I've studied for decades.
So, like, what are some of those news sources that you turn to for getting your information?
Well, I mean, there's plenty of alternative news on the internet. You know, there's tons of it. But the main thing is actually reading the books and understanding the plan from the controllers of the society that we live in. And that, you know, you can research.
And who are some of those controllers, in your opinion?
Well, there's no, it's not even an opinion, it's just a fact. You're talking about the global elite families that run the Federal Reserve banking system, actually basically all of the central banks around the
Yeah,
world. So, you
this
know,
has been a topic you've spoken a lot about, I know, the Fed.
it's absolutely the way the world works. So you start with reading The Creature from Jekyll Island, research the Council on Foreign Relations, Trilateral Commission, Bilderberg. You know, all of these things are real, they're happening, and you're never going to hear about it on the mainstream news because that's the control, they're the gatekeepers of what's happening. And it's not paranoid conspiracy theory, it's a conspiracy fact. And anybody that is naive enough to think that people with power would not conspire to keep their power is living in a fucking fantasy, period.
So now,
So I mean,
how
in
do you
terms of,
reconcile this with the fact that people clearly are dying? You know, I mean, you know, I've had friends, family members that have been ill, friends of mine in the medical community work in hospitals and, you know, and see face to face with death every day. You know, like, are you saying, what exactly are you saying about that?
well, I mean, I'm not saying that we don't have a problem. I'm saying that if somebody gets in a car crash and has the genetic material of a coronavirus, which we all, most of us have because we've had colds and flus in our life, you know, you can get it. They're classifying everything as a COVID-related death, man. I mean, just look into it. I'm not going to get into this debate with you where I'm here to promote my book, and like
And we're going to
this is,
talk
you
about the
know,
book, don't worry.
yeah. I mean, this is like, it's just, I'm not buying it. You know, I'm not buying it hook, line, and sinker. I've seen the video footage. Most of the hospitals are empty, and it's a gigantic level of fraud. People die all the time, dude. We don't shut down the fucking world. If you want me to believe for a minute that the governments around the world love the population so much that they're willing to collapse society, I'm gonna call bullshit on that. These people are murdering scum.
Well, I don't think
Period.
they want to, you know. I mean, I think we have a situation where, you know, like our the current administration in the U.S., for example, very much wants the economy to get, well, you know, I mean, everyone wants the economy to get back, but certainly the administration is pushing for that to happen soon. You know, but I think what you're seeing is that there's side effects of that, and it's that a lot of people are dying. You know, first it was mostly in the Northeast, where I am, and you know, and thankfully we've kind of got it under control. And now you're seeing it, which was why I actually asked you about Florida, like places like Florida, Texas, Arizona, where a lot of people are in the hospital. You know, it's not a news illusion. The hospitals are filling up, and they're filling up quickly. And you know, my friends who are medical workers here in the Northeast or in other places that experienced this months ago are, you know, face to face with deaths, and they're telling me about the beds that are full and the people that they're seeing dying and so on and so forth. I mean, you know,
Okay, well, you know, that's your view, and I just happen to disagree. I was just
I
in
mean.
Florida for a while, and it's just not that bad. It's just not.
I mean,
Okay.
so are you saying that?
There's way more testing going on, and there are perfectly healthy people coming down that are being tested. And look, dude, just look at the way, look at the guy that invented the test and said, you don't use this. And this is years ago. You don't use this for determining viral testing. They're testing genetic material, which most humans have. just look into it. We need to move along because I'm not getting into all this in a, 25-minute interview to try to explain to you or anybody else the thousands of hours of research that I've done. I'm telling you, you look at these criminals like Bill Gates and Fauci, and they are fucking criminals, and there is a plan, and it's all to vaccinate everybody and look out because this is a death cult that is running this whole situation.
All right. Well, I
So.
mean, we this is called the quarantine cast, and this
Yes.
was, the in large part the discussion topic of this particular series is kind of to talk about some of these issues, but so it shouldn't really be a surprise to you, but also,
Well, it is a surprise to me because I was told I was doing an interview for Metal Sucks website. Nobody said anything about that
Well, we
this is
are. This will
supposed to be
be,
about the
it's
corn.
right here on the camera. And like I said, we're going to talk about your book, and I want to know about that. I also want to know what you've been doing during this time.
I've been
When,
working, man. I've been working. Yeah, I've put together a book since Christmas. The idea hit me and worked with tons of artists to make that happen. I've produced the Witherfall record during all this, just finished it a couple days ago. Just finished the mix, produced it here. Well, we did have to push it back. It should have been done in mid-May.
Jake's an old buddy of mine.
Yeah, cool. Well, that's so we have made a great record. It's fantastic. And so that's I've been doing a lot. I've been staying. I don't really sit idle. I don't really I mean, we our movement has definitely been hindered because of all this. And I don't know when my band's going to be able to get back together because there's all these criminal governors all over the state saying there's never going to be another public gathering until there's a vaccine. Well, fuck you. There's nobody's going to forcefully vaccinate me. Not happening. I know the agenda. So, that's like basically war for me and for many people that I know. So, my band is international and we have one of our members is in Canada and one is in the UK and I just don't know when it's going to be when we're going to be able to get back together again. And I think there's a lot of politics involved in this whole situation as well. So we'll just have to see. I'm not worried because there's plenty of work and I've got another production starting in 2 weeks. Big surprise that's coming. That's going to be killer. So, I'm going to stay busy because there's plenty of things that I can do creatively that don't require touring, and that kind of stuff. But it's going to be difficult for Iced Earth because, these are these guys that are international mean the world to me that are in my band. So, we're not. I'm not just gonna, we just have to wait and see. Have to play it out.
Well, it's a weird time for the music industry for that reason. It seems like
Oh.
you're uniquely situated to kind of weather the storm here, at least like financially. You said you have some production work, and maybe we'll see some other music from you, who knows. But in the meantime, you do have this book,
And
Wicked
yeah,
Words and
hey, to
Epic
get back.
Tales. From what I understand, it's kind of like a compendium of stuff from throughout your career. It's artwork, it's lyrics, it's interviews. It's sort of an overarching, almost like coffee table book of John Schaefer's work. Is that basically the gist?
Yeah, kind of. It's not, the interview thing. There's not really. There's I man, when the Kickstarter campaign started, I started producing the Witherfall album. So I haven't actually I started before that launched. So there's a few things that just aren't really factually correct. There is one interview in there. It's not like a an anthology of interviews with me. There's chapter header pages into each chapter, each album release that I've put out from all four of my band's projects, and tons of artwork. And then all of the lyrics since 1984, I think, is one of the oldest songs that's in there that I've written. So I mean, all of those are in there, and but it is a coffee table style book. It's got a CD in it. It's going to be at least 250 pages. We're just now starting the paginating process. So it's a whole, look, the whole idea of this is I have been planning on doing graphic novels and comics and action figures and gaming and all that stuff for years, ever since I created the Something Wicked story back in, I initially created it in 1997. And the first album that it was exposed to the public on was Something Wicked This Way Comes, with the trilogy at the end of that record. So this has always been my long-term plan, at to the point when I decide to retire from music, was to go into this direction. So, I'm not saying I'm there yet, but it is coming. And I don't want to be on stage into my 70s. I just don't. I've done a lot. Since I was a 16-year-old kid, I've accomplished and done a lot in the last 35 years. And so I'm definitely, it's coming. And I got all these other creative, artistic things that I want to chase that have been going on in my head. And so this book is a cool way to learn how to self-publish, to reconnect with all these artists that I not some of these guys I've worked with in the past. There's many people that I haven't worked with, but I've gotten connected with a lot of people, and to put plans in motion going forward. So that's the idea. So I started Wicked Tales as a new publishing company, where more characters are going to be revealed in this book from the Something Wicked story, and as things go forward, it's going to continually go. You know what I mean? So it's a pretty cool thing, and the reaction's been good. Like, this idea, I hadn't seen anything like this. I mean, I figured that there were some poetry books, and maybe somebody had done a lyric book, but when this hit me, I just thought that, if any of my favorite writers, whether it's Steve Harris or Geezer Butler, Neil Peart, Roger Waters, those are some of my favorite writers of all time. And if any of those guys would come out with a book like I was imagining in my head, I would definitely have jumped all over it. So I just gave it a shot, man. I just had this kind of a vision in my mind of what I wanted to chase, and decided, I built the whole thing and got a lot of tons of the work. Actually, by the time we started the Kickstarter campaign, except for one piece of art, it's done. So, we just got to paginate now and put it together. And I wasn't sure how the people would react. I had no idea, but I figured Kickstarter would tell me, and that at least let me know how many copies to press and to get, to get out there. And I mean, it doubled the funding pledge in one day, and now it's four times what I started off with. So
That's
it's
great.
going great. Yeah, it's cool. I mean, it's different. The narrative thing, it was an idea to go along with the book, and I thought that just reading along with these lyrics would be boring, because we were talking about, doing an audio book, but I wanted to make it something more interesting. So instead of just reading through the lyrics on however many songs are in there, I don't even know right now. It's 150 or something. Like, it's a crazy amount of lyrics. And and I just decided, instead of doing that, let me focus in on, a CD's worth length, and just create a cool soundtrack to it, so that it's not a song and it's not really an audio book. It's somewhere in between, and it can be played on both formats. It could be an Audible thing. It could be on Spotify. How many people will want to re-listen to this? I have no idea. It seems like people are digging the lyric videos and stuff, but it's just a cool bonus to the book. That's it,
Yeah, and that comes with only the deluxe edition, am I right? The CD.
Yeah, so far that's the only addition. There may be a point where we do a soft cover, like a trade paperback. I don't know if you're familiar with the comic and graphic novel world, but a lot of times things will come out that are, at a reduced price, because this is expensive. This is a really expensive thing to put together because of all of the artwork. I mean, there's a ton of artwork in there. Sorry about that.
Happens.
And the quality of the materials. I mean, this is a all the full color. There is no like typical printed text page like you would get in a book. It's every page is full color. Even the lyric pages,
And
they
can you
are
talk
all.
about that, the artwork a bit? Because my understanding is there's a lot of different artists that are contributing to the artwork in the book.
Yeah, there's a lot. I mean, it's all different incarnations of Set, mostly my character. There are new introductions of characters, Queen Jezebel being one of them, the Slaven another, Guardians of the Wicked, which are basically Set's parents, though he he's not conceived in, through intercourse, so it isn't like that. But these are the couple that's chosen to look after him in his early years. So it's a very diverse art style. There's some guys that have more in the Frank Frazetta Boris style painting, like Lucio Perillo. He did a really badass version of Set. And then Sun Kamunaki did a couple pieces. Richard Ortiz, who's from Uruguay, he did four pieces in the book, and most of those are homage pieces. So there's like an homage to Spawn number one, homage to Batman 251, Marvel. It's basically the first issue of Son of Satan. I think it was called Marvel Spotlight number 12, and that's a pretty cool, and that's like, it has me in there also. So there's like the one that's Batman. It's Batman and the Joker is an homage to that, but it's Set and me. And then we did one to an homage to Number of the Beast. So it's Set and me, and then a little baby Set, So I mean, there's some cool stuff in there. But some of it is directly relevant to certain songs that I've written, and some of it is just interpretations of Set by these different artists. So it's like
Almost
a
like fan art kind of thing,
well.
like fan fiction in a way.
Not really, because these are serious professional illustrators.
Well,
So, you
yeah, I know. No, I didn't mean that as like a, belittling term, but like inspired by kind of thing.
yeah,
Yeah, yeah.
it's with me giving the artist direction, and saying that this is where I want this to go, and then we work through it.
Oh,
And
I see. So
some,
these are like commissioned pieces specifically
yes,
for this purpose. Oh, I gotcha.
yes, yeah, absolutely,
I see.
yeah.
All
So
right,
they'll
cool.
they'll be used, in some way in the future for probably when it comes to actually doing the graphic novel series. But that's also going to be a whole nother level, you know what I mean, of getting into the Something Wicked story, because this story can go on forever. I mean, it's basically limitless, like Star Trek or Star Wars in terms of storytelling. It's a framework that you can apply to any point in human history, and it's kind of, it's like it's horror, science fiction, dystopian, real history. It's a mix of everything, and that's what makes it really fun storytelling.
Yeah, I was thinking of Star Trek as you were saying that. I remember like going to the bookstore as a kid and seeing that there were like other Star Trek books that had nothing to do with like, the movies and being like, poof, just like blew my mind. So like what, so when are we going to expect to see this? I know you're still kickstarting it, but do you have any kind of timeline for when this may come to be available to folks?
The plan is to have it out by Halloween. So as long as we can, once the campaign ends and we have a fairly short window after that to get everything off to the pressing plant, or the printing plant in this case. I'm used to records. But so no, that's the target is Halloween, and I hope that people will have it by then. It may be a little bit after. It just depends also on how fast the paginating goes, because that's really where we've got everything designed. All of the chapter header pages, the lyric pages, any of the text, all of the artwork, all that stuff is there, but it's a very meticulous process to go through and start paginating. And we just got the templates for that yesterday, so we're going to get started on it like right away.
Cool. I
And
did see a preview of some of it, and it looked great. So, certainly looking forward to that. In the meantime, is there any new Iced Earth material in the works?
there's not right now. Like I said, I'm not even in the headspace, to be honest with you. I need a break, because I had 6 releases in 14 months. So, coming off the heels of a pretty intense, touring period, and the Demons and Wizards thing was huge. I mean, that was an unbelievable amount of work that Hansi and I pulled off in a very short amount of time. So I'm just kind of at a point where I need to take a hiatus for a little while. And besides that, with all this shit going on, there's not much that we can do, because I can't, another Demons and Wizards record is one thing. That's definitely on the agenda at some point in the next few years. But with Iced Earth, I need my guys to be at Independence Hall recording. It's not going to be the kind of thing where I can have them just go and record. If I'm putting together for a Demons and Wizards record, if I'm putting together the music here, then I have all the confidence in the world that Hansi can take care of vocals on his own in Germany, and we can deal with a mix. You know, that's easy. Iced Earth is a different scenario. So we have to just see how things unfold in the world here. But come September, I've got another production starting. There's going to be music. It's going to be really badass. That's coming, starting in just a few weeks, and you'll hear about it. But
Can't say what
then,
it is yet. We'll
no,
hear about it.
you'll hear about it. I can't say what it is yet. It's a big surprise.
Fair
But
enough.
after that's done, and from September on for a while, I'm off, and then I'm going to wait and see how the global situation plays out, and then we'll put a battle plan together after that. But in terms of Iced Earth right now, it's on hold because it's an international band, and there's no point in trying to make any plans that all, and this is the thing that really pisses me off about all this. I mean, there's a lot of things that really piss me off about all this, but a lot of my colleagues are really suffering. The good thing for Hansi and I, compared to many of our friends and colleagues in this business, is that we had not planned on touring for Iced Earth, Blind Guardian, or Demons and Wizards in 2020. This was going to be a year focused on productions and studio work for me, and Hansi's right now working on the new Blind Guardian. His guys all live in the same town, except for Frederick. He lives a couple hours away. But so for him, they can still carry on with their production, and that's good. But you know what's happened to so many bands that when you launch a tour, there's a big financial outlay, you know, and bands started their tours and then had it pulled, yanked right from under them a week into it, 2 weeks into it, a month into it. That's not enough time to recoup your costs, you know, depending on how big the production is and how many months of touring was planned. And now you got Live Nation coming out and saying that mid-level tours are all going to be doors only. How the fuck is anybody supposed to budget a tour for them? How, you know, what is this going to
I'm
mean
hearing the
for?
same thing, and it is going to be very, very difficult.
Yeah, dude, and it's all fraud, man. It's garbage, and it's just meant to shut society down. And I don't know. I mean, you know, it's supposed to be we the people, not we the sheeple. People need to really start thinking and start researching and understanding what we're up against, because I'm telling you right now, it's not good. This whole thing,
Well, I
this
agree that
whole
it's not good, but I don't agree that it's by design. But
well,
you know, like, look, if you've got sources, please send them, and we'll check them out. This is your chance to, you know, to get the message out.
read The Creature from Jekyll Island. I mean, I've been saying that for years. I had a whole list of sources that on a Sons of Liberty website that got shut down twice, leaving Eddie Trunk's studio. By the time I did Andrew Napolitano's show on Fox Business on a Friday, and on a Sunday I was at Eddie Trunk's doing a nationwide broadcast on Sirius. By the time I left Rockefeller Center and was on my way to the hotel in the limousine, my website was shut down. All it was a site saying, read these books, check out these videos, think for yourself. Okay? There's literally hundreds of books on the subject. It's literally about understanding history. That's what it is. And understanding the manipulators and how far things have fallen and where we're headed. I can sit here and give everybody a list of books. The problem is people don't fucking read anymore. Okay? That's one of the big problems. It's easier just to be told the narrative, and then everybody goes around like good little slaves and parrots everything they hear. I don't do that. I don't play that game. I understand what's happening, and they're not going to destroy my constitutional republic without a fight. It's not going to happen, you know, and there's a lot of people that feel that way. So we'll see where all this goes. I'm not playing the game. I will not comply.
Well, what
Not
will
that
you
fast.
do? And I mean, it seems like you have a plan, but you know, I mean, like, what's your method of fighting back?
Well, we'll see what happens. You know, forced vaccinations, that's my line in the sand. You know,
I don't personally, I don't think there will be forced vaccinations. That doesn't seem likely to me, but you know, I don't know.
Well, okay, if it's not forced, but they make it impossible for you to do commerce, to travel, to go to events, because then you don't have it, you're being forced.
Well, it's a
You know what
public
I mean?
health, you know, I mean, I understand that, because it's not just you, it's everybody around you.
Well, you're buying into the narrative pretty good, man. I'll send you a list of books. I
I'm
mean,
happy to do it. I feel
yeah.
like I'm doing my part, and I'm minding my business. I'm staying safe and keeping
If
those
you know
around me
what,
safe.
if you replace the word safe with controlled, that's actually what's happening.
I mean, that may
Like
also be true, but I would rather be controlled in quotes than, get my parents sick and have them die.
well, I hear you, but that's also buying into a narrative. I mean, we were
I don't
told
really care that if
so
the
much.
narrative is keeping my parents alive, I'm okay with that. Like that's what it comes down to.
Okay. Well,
Yeah.
you got your priorities. Freedom is my priority.
All
So,
right. Yeah.
I'm not, I don't trust the government. I'm not naive. I don't trust the media whatsoever. I don't trust Hollywood. Lying fucking
I
scum.
mean, I agree with you on many of those things. I just also do not want to propagate death within my family and friends. Like
Yeah,
that's.
if that was really the case, I would, dude, I'd be right there with you, except that it's just not exactly the
It
truth.
is though, man. I mean, I'm telling you, I know people who have been very ill and died. It's not. I'm not making it up.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm not saying you're making it up, and I'm sorry for your loss. People do die. That's happened throughout human history.
Yeah,
They will
I
die.
mean, more
We don't
people than
shut down
usual
the
because
fucking
of this
world.
specific thing that is
We don't
incredibly infectious.
shut down the world and start worshiping tyranny because people die. I mean, there has been pandemics forever on this planet, and this is not even close to stuff that has happened in the last century. So it's,
It's
come
pretty
on, man.
bad, man. A lot of people have died.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep. All right.
If
Well,
you
thanks for
trust the
joining us,
stats,
John. And
yeah, you got it, man.
you stay safe out there, all right?
Yeah, I'll stay free.